The International Monetary Fund, the IMF, had made a statement recently about the economic situation in Egypt, as it says that the latest procedures that was taken by Egypt recently shows to the investors that Egypt is serious about its economic reform, and these steps were the currency floating and cutting the subsidies. To talk more about the latest procedures regarding economy, we are joined by Professor of Economy and Commercial Law, Dr. Marwa Zain Al-Abidine. Hello and welcome to Nar Cruise.
Hi, welcome.
Welcome with us, Doctor. Now, the significance of such a statement by the managing director of the IMF, especially that she said that the country is on the right track when it comes to its economic reform, that also the inflation is expected to drop by 12% this year. How do you see that?
This is perceived generally as the policy that is implemented for economic and legislative reform is on the right track, and we are implementing what we have planned to. It could have significant negative effects on the market, but it's going to be cured later on after finalizing implementing that policy of economic and legislative reform.
And how long it's going to take to be cured these negative effects?
I couldn't give you a specific date, but we are on process. The inflation rate going to be developed for a certain extent in the coming couple of months, but in a significant date to tell you exactly when the negative effects will be cured, it's not that much accurate.
One of the things she mentioned also was the start of small franchises, and that would lead us to talking about SMEs. Now, how do you see the current laws in Egypt and the procedures implemented by the government in terms to encourage SMEs in Egypt, and what do we need?
Okay, let's best define what is the SMEs, small enterprises.
Yes.
We are the legislations recently were implemented, mm-hmm. and also the economic reform plan is really encouraging the SMEs, mm-hmm. and encouraging small and medium investors to start their business. Mm-hmm. It could help in two aspects, nationally mm-hmm. and internationally. Mm-hmm. So the legislations nearly at the end of 2016, there were a couple of legislations talking about compensating contractors. The contractors are considered under this criteria. They were compensated due to the economic reform that had happened, compensated on the ongoing project they were implementing. Mm-hmm. So economically, we are on the right track and encouraging those SMEs and also the international and investors. Also, in the legislative side, we are focusing on developing the legislations, and we are going to talk later on about the investment law, the new investment law that was implemented at the first beginning of that year. So legislatively and economically, I guess we are going on the right track.
Why the procedures in order to make a reform in economy, the procedures are so harsh, and those who feel it are the normal people, of course, and those who are in the market. So why it start hard and at the end it's becoming flexible and smooth?
Sure, you know that we do have a dramatic change in the economic society and environment in Egypt, and it should be done like that. We don't have any other solution. Now we are just developing what had happened out of those dramatic movements in the economy and also in the legislations. We now are taking further steps into the investment law. The investment law is opening many opportunities, minimizing the procedures of starting an investment or starting a business. But it should have its reflect on the society, and we have to bear this.
Recently, President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi inaugurated the Investment Service Center via video call in Elminia, and they changed the name from the One Window Stop to the One Ceiling, mm-hmm. in a sense, to give the idea of the inclusiveness. Yes.
Yes.
How do you see that?
It's very productive thing, and it will be helpful, very, very helpful, whether for the investors or for the SMEs. It will facilitate many, many things. We have to cut the red tape. We have to minimize the procedures. It takes many, many time to start a business. This would facilitate the procedures. This would facilitate starting a business, and also it has its effect in the economy. Since you have facilitated the procedures, it will. You can easily start your business. You can easily start your small project, whether it's small project or a large project. It will quickly be reflected in the economy.
Christine Lagarde's statements about Egypt. She praised the latest economic steps taken by Egypt regarding economy, and she said, of course, that Egypt is serious about reform. Although there are hard steps to be taken, like floating the economy and floating the currency and cutting these subsidies. On what basis she measures that there will be positive effects later?
Generally, the IMF is monitoring the implementation of the plan that was agreed with them at the first beginning before the grant. So they are following on each step of implementation. This has great two aspects, the economic and the legislative. And we are exactly implementing the plan that was agreed was the International Monetary Fund by its exact steps. That's why, based on what she is talking about plans and implementation, she's talking about documentation. But she's not talking about the general case of the society, the general case of the economic environment in Egypt. She's talking by documents.
Doctor, you've mentioned previously, as we were talking, that you'd like to talk about the new investment law. So would you elaborate on that, please?
The new investment law encouraged the investment in many, many aspects. It's also integrated the society in the procedures and in what we could say that it's the outcome of the investment. We have facilitated many, many things, or the legislator is facilitating many, many things for the investor in the investment law, and also putting some, not restrictions, or recommendations to be done, like the involving the society, like the responsibility of this investor toward the society. And this could conclude at the end of the day the full vision of governance, which is the cooperation between the public sector and private sector, and also the society. This would help to develop the economic environment in Egypt, and also the grants is granted under this law facilitate the start of the business in Egypt, which will attract more investors. So I consider this law is one of the major and very effective tools to implement the economic reform policy.
Okay, Christine Lagarde said also, although Egypt took the right steps in its economic reform, but there are yet other steps to be taken in order to be moving on the right path. Other steps, of course, regarding the gas, the bills in electricity and water, and others to come. How do you see these coming procedures will affect people and the market?
Sure, it would have its negative effects on the market and people, and especially people. Maybe the investor, they are talking about money and they are investing and they are intending to enlarge their fortunes. But the citizens are the most criteria in that whole image that is really affected by that reform. But in order to we will be affected, mm-hmm. and we have to admit this, but it has to be done like this. Mm-hmm. And in order to reform your economy, you have to take just good steps.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Doctor, recently the parliament ratified the bankruptcy law. How do you see that, and to what extent can that help the companies which is in debt to reschedule its debt?
Of course, the economy will be affected by the number of entities that declared bankruptcy. Mm. So in order to help them rather than to put criminal sanctions on them, it will if you penalize them, you will not get your money that it has spent, and it will be mm-hmm. lost in the economic market or in the economic society. Mm-hmm. So rescheduling the debts and rescheduling and putting them on track is, I guess, it's much more beneficial than just put on them criminal sanctions.
Mm-hmm. Regarding, of course, the economy nowadays, What are the other steps should be taken to refresh the economy and to encourage investors to come to Egypt and invest here?
From the legislative perspective, it's done. The law contains many aspects of attraction for the investors. And now it's the role of the Ministry of Investment, the Ministry of International Trade, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. It's their role to market for this law. If the aspects of the law were marketed well, I guess it will attract the investors and will come to invest here without any fears of losing their money.
Doctor, one of the fields that the government is concentrating on when it comes to economic reform and increasing the GDP of the country is energy, and especially with the latest discovery of the Zohr field. And we had recently also the president, he was holding a big mega event for the start of the phase of Al Zohr field. So how do you see that and the effect of it on the economy?
It could be perceived as a great push for the economy. Mm-hmm. Discovering such thing, which is Al Zohr, it would encourage the economy. It will maintain some to a certain extent stability in the future for the energy. Energy is most important thing in order to establish factories, in order for the normal citizens' life. Mm-hmm. So it could get a great push regarding the stability in the future.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you very much for joining us, Dr. Marwa Zine El Abidine.
You're
for joining us today, and welcome to Nile Cruise.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, thank you again, Dr. Marwa Zine El Abidine, the professor of economy and commercial law. Thank you very much for this interview. And now we will be going to a quick break, but we'll be back for more on Nile Cruise. Stay with us.